Hi everyone, this is Dr. Tanushree Pandey, an obstetrician and gynecologist, and I'm here to talk to you about 10 things about your vagina that you did not know. The thing that you see on the outside, the lips with the hair, that's not the vagina. That's in fact the vulva. So the vulva has the vaginal lips, which is the labia majora and the minora, the pubic hair, the vaginal opening, the opening of the vaginal canal, and the clitoris. The vagina actually is inside, well hidden behind the vulva. And it's like a canal, or a box, or a room. It's almost 6 inches in some people. Next time, you do not shave your vagina, you cannot do that. You actually shave your pubic hair, which is in the vulva, which is not the vagina. Coming to the second point, the clitoris. The opening of the vagina right above it is the pea-sized clitoris, which is not actually pea-sized. It's almost 10 centimeters length to length. It has hoods and wings, and that's where most women climax from. So next time the penetration in the vagina doesn't really work out for you, you're not abnormal. Most women climax with clitoral stimulation or blended stimulation, which is the vagina and the clitoris being stimulated together. So you're normal, your clitoris is normal, go and have some fun. The third thing, vaginismus. Have you heard about vaginismus? Vaginismus is real. It is when your vagina, the muscles of your vagina go into spasm and they cannot let anything penetrate in. So like I said, the vagina is a canal, but it's in spasm and so it completely shuts down. And no, the penis or anything else cannot penetrate in. It happens when you've been undergoing some sort of sexual assault or you are sexually unhappy, you're going through stress, there's lack of foreplay, there's something hidden within you and you need counseling, you need to seek help. You cannot manage it yourself. Talk to your partner, seek help. Vaginismus is real, it's not your fault. Well, that is normal, commonly known as a vaginal fart. It's not actually a fart, it doesn't smell bad. It's just air trapped in the vaginal canal and it comes out as a sound, as a fart or poof. And it's normal and it's just a creep and you're just supposed to laugh it off, have fun, relax, enjoy. The vagina can almost increase in size to up to 200 times of its original size. And that normally happens during childbirth. So it is perfectly normal for your vagina to expand, let the baby come out, and it's going to come to its normal size. There will obviously be certain postpartum changes, and that is absolutely normal. So the changes that happen in a woman's breast, happens in your skin, it's a part of aging, it's a part of being a mother, and it's perfectly normal. But through proper pelvic floor exercises, you're going to regain your size of your vagina, and you're not going to be loose, you're not going to be unhappy, and the vagina is not going to always remain the size of a head of a baby, and it's going to shrink back to almost its original size. Vaginal tears are normal, they happen during childbirth. Sometimes the doctor gives an artificial vaginal tear known as an episiotomy, and the vagina has a lot of blood vessels, so it heals on its own and you don't need to worry, your vagina is going to be fine. All people with vaginas do not identify themselves as women. So necessarily your organ, the vagina or the penis, doesn't decide whether you're a man or a woman. Sometimes people with a vagina identify themselves as men or non-binary. So be sensitive, not all people with vaginas are women. Nothing in your vagina is getting lost ever, my friend. No, don't let anybody tell you that you can't use a menstrual cup, you can't use a tampon, because no, the vagina is like a closed canal, so it's an entry from one side, but it's closed from here. So nothing, closed in the sense it has the cervix and the uterus, but nothing is really getting lost. So the tampon may go a little high up, the menstrual cup might get stuck for a few seconds, but it's going to come out and nothing is getting lost in your vagina. The vagina is a self-cleansing mechanism. So what do I mean by self-cleansing mechanism of the vagina? It automatically takes out certain discharges, the elastic discharges, the slightly white discharge that you get, which is normal. The vagina self-cleanses itself. It gets rid of all the bad bacteria. maintains the pH, and it's a beautiful organ. It takes care of itself. So next time, don't put in some perfume soap. Douche yourself. No, those are not recommended, and you do not need. You're not supposed to smell of roses down there. Yes, the vagina has a smell of its own. The pungent smell, the tangy smell, whatever you want to call it. That is how your vagina is supposed to smell. Everybody's vagina smells differently. And please stop being embarrassed of it. That's the way vaginas are supposed to smell. So if you're somebody with a vagina, be proud, my friends. And I hope you learned from this video, because the vagina is a mysterious yet beautiful organ.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any videos by us.